Hey Divi Nation, thank you for joining us in this live stream. And today I will show you how to create a game scoreboard using Divi's Soccer Club Layout Pack. If you haven't checked that out yet, make sure that you do. I've mentioned the link in the description below. And if you're not an Elegant Themes member yet, make sure that you check out Divi. I've mentioned a link to the product page where you can go ahead and discover Divi for yourself. So without any further ado, let's get to it. All right, so let's take a look at the soccer club layout pack. So this is the overall look and feel that you can expect from it. It is clean, but it has all of the elements that you would need to set up a soccer club website. It has high quality images included as well, which are free to use without any restrictions, even for commercial purposes. So what we're going to do within this live stream tutorial is create a scoreboard. So if you're a soccer club, if you run a soccer club, it might be nice to show the latest game and the result that goes along with that. And this is the initial design that we're going to create. So here you have it. And let me show you what it looks like on tablet and phone as well. But we're using elements on desktop and tablet and mobile separately. So you won't be able to see the entire end result, but you'll have, you know what you'll be able to expect from it. So this is the tablet and mobile version. So over here you have some elements that are hidden just to make it match with the screen size that it's displayed on. And then we have this end result on phone as well. So this is part of the desktop version. And here we have the look and feel on phone. All right, so let's get started. To create this tutorial, the primary thing you will need is the soccer club landing page. So I've already installed it on my website, but feel free to do that. And once you do, go ahead and enable the visual builder. All right, so then we'll continue by adding a new section. And we're going to add it right here, right below the, not right above the club sponsor. So I'll continue by adding a regular section and without adding any rows or modules, I'm going to open the section settings and I'll change the background color into the following color code. So if you want to find all of these steps written down, or all of the color codes, you can go ahead and go to the blog post, which I've linked in the description below, where you can find everything explained to you step by step as well. And then we're also going to change the spacing settings. So I'll go to the design tab, open the spacing settings over here, and I'm going to add some top and bottom padding. So 55 for the top and 140 pixels for the bottom. And then the next thing we're going to do is add a title over here, but to save ourselves some time, we're going to clone this row over here and place the duplicate in the new section. And we're just going to change the text. So I'm choosing latest game scoreboard over here. And then we're going to add a new row. And this row will have three columns. So this one over here. And before adding any modules, we're going to open the row settings and we're going to give our row a white background color. Then we'll add a background color to the first column as well. And we'll use the same color code for the column three background color. And then we'll go to the design tab over here and change the sizing settings. So we're going to enable custom gutter width over here and we're going to give it a value of 1. And we're also going to equalize the column heights. And then we'll go to the spacing settings and over here we'll get rid of the custom padding by adding 0 pixels to the top and bottom custom padding. As you can see, the white that was here before is gone. And we'll also add a border to match with the layout pack, so the soccer club layout pack. And to do that, we'll go to the border settings over here and we'll add 1 to the top and to the bottom. And we're using 8 pixels and the following color code. So I'm just going to repeat that for the bottom border as well and use the same border color. We're also going to give it a subtle box shadow just to add a little bit more depth to the page and to the game scoreboard. And I'm going to enable this first option over here, and I'm going to use a vertical position of 20 pixels, 80 pixels for the blur strength. So this was supposed to be the vertical position, not the horizontal one, and minus 20 pixels for the spread strength over here. And then we'll also change the shadow color into one that's a little bit less transparent. And now we can go ahead and add the various models. So I'm just going to save this really quick, and I'll just show you the end result once again. So these are all the modules that we'll need. We'll start with the first column. Afterwards, we'll be able to clone these modules and use them for the third column as well. And then we'll start working on the second column over here. So the first thing we will need there is a text module. So go ahead and add a text module to the first column. And over here, you can place some content of your choice. I'm just going to enter winning team. Then I'm going to give this text module a slightly darker background color. Again, you can find all of these steps and color codes by going to the blog post, which I've mentioned in the description below, or you can just read all of the settings off the screen as well if you prefer to do that. So the next thing we'll do is change the text settings to make it match with the layout pack. So we're using Squadda 1 as the font. We're also enabling uppercase over here. We're giving it a different text color. We'll also change the text size to 20 pixels. And we'll use center text orientation. And then to give this text module a little bit more space to breathe, we're going to add some custom padding values. So we'll use 10 pixels for the top and the bottom, and for the left and the right side as well. This will make sure that it appears nicely on tablet and phone as well, where the screen size is smaller. Okay, time to add the next module. Again, we're using a text module, and over here you can add the club name. So I'm just using one that is used in the layout pack as well. Then I'm going to the text settings. I'm going to change the text font into Open Sans. I think the default one is Open Sans as well, so I could have left it the way it was, but just to make sure. And then I'm going to choose bold for the text font weight as well. And I'll change the text color into the same color that I've used for the previous text module over there. And I'll change the text size as well to 18 pixels. And I'll enable text orientation, center text orientation over here. And to create a little bit more space between these two modules, we're going to add some custom padding next. So we'll use 20 pixels for both the top and the bottom. And the next thing we'll need, the next thing and the last thing I think it is that we'll need is an image module. And over here you can add the club logo of the team this column is representing. I'm just using a placeholder over here, but you can choose whichever one you want to. So probably the one that you're creating for your own team. And to make this a little bit more centered with the other modules, we're going to change the sizing settings, and we'll use different values for the different screen sizes. So I'm going to enable the mobile icon over here, and I'm going to use 45% for desktop, 16 for tablet, and 28 for phone. And I'm also going to enable center module alignment. And again, we're going to create some space for this module by adding some custom margin over here. So we'll use 20 pixels for the top margin and 50 pixels for the bottom margin. You could easily use these values for the custom padding one as well. In this case, they will do the same thing. So we have all of the modules in the first column. So we're just going to clone each one of these modules and place them in the third column for the opponent team. So here we're going to write opponent. Okay. And we'll change the content here as well. And now we can move on to the second column, and over here we'll have the following result. So again, we'll add a text module. We're going to enter the date. We'll add a background color that matches the layout pack. And then we'll change the text settings. So again, we're using Squadra 1 as the font, and we're enabling uppercase using a white text color, 40 to 42 pixels for the text size, and we'll enable center text orientation. Then we'll go to the spacing settings and add some custom padding, 30 pixels to both the top and the bottom of this text modules, this text module. And the last thing we'll need to do over here is change the visibility. So we're going to hide this on tablet and phone because we'll create an alternative. So preferably we want these two modules to appear first, and that's why we're using these modules separately on tablet and phone. So they will be part of the first column, so they will appear first when somebody scrolls through your page. Okay, so now we can add the second module, which will represent the score. And let's say it's going to be 3-2. We'll also change the text settings over here. We're using Squadra 1 again. And we're changing the text color. This is the color code that you would need. We're using 150 pixels. We're changing the text line height into 1. We'll use center text orientation. Then we'll go to the spacing settings, and we're going to apply some different spacing values over here. So we'll start with the top margin, and this is going to be different on desktop and smaller screen sizes. So I'm going to give it 40 pixels to the top and 20 pixels for tablet and phone. So if you add 20 pixels to the top, for tablet, it will automatically apply to the phone version as well. And we'll also add 20 pixels for the bottom on tablet and phone. And then we'll add some custom padding to the left and right size, so we're sure that it doesn't touch the borders on smaller screen sizes. And again, we're going to hide this module on tablet and phone in the visibility settings in the advanced tab. And now that we have both these modules over here, we can clone both of them and place them in the first column. And the only thing that you will need to change over here is the visibility. So disable it on desktop and allow it to show on phone and tablet. So do that for each one of these two modules. All right. So now we can move on to the second row, which is the following one. This is going to be the desktop version. After this row, we'll also need one for tablet and phone. So the column structure that we'll be using are three columns over here. And without adding any modules, go ahead and open the row settings and give your row a white background color. And add another background color for the second column. So this will be the stroke that we have over here. And then go to the sizing settings, and we're going to remove all of the space between the three columns by enabling a use custom gutter width over here and using one as the value. And we're also going to equalize the column heights. Then go to the spacing settings, and as you can see over here, there is some space at the top and the bottom. That's the default padding that is applied to rows. And to get rid of that, we're just going to add 0 pixels to the top and the bottom custom padding. And we're also going to add some column padding. We will use 100 pixels for the column 1 bottom padding and 10 pixels for the right padding. And 10 pixels for the left padding for column 3. And this will just make sure that once we add the modules, they won't be pressed against the second column. They'll still have a bit of space over there, but not too much. We're just using 10 pixels. So I'll just show you. As you can see over here, we have a little bit of space. That's the 10 pixels that we're adding. And we'll also add a bottom border over here to match the layout back. Again, we're using 8 pixels and the following color code for the border color. And we'll add the same kind of box shadow here as well. We're enabling the first option over here, adding 20 pixels. Over here, 80 pixels here, and minus 20 for the spread strength. And we'll change the shadow color. So this is the same box shadow that we've added to the first row. So you can go ahead and just copy those settings and paste them over here if you want to. I didn't think it was necessary because there were only a few steps to take. And then we're also going to hide this row on tablet and phone. As I've mentioned before, we'll create another row for smaller screen sizes, which will match better. So, okay, time to add the modules. So we're using text modules and we're getting the following results. So as you can see over here, this is the time someone made a goal and the person's name over here. So we'll start with the first text module. And we're going to give it some content, and we're also going to change the color of the minutes over here. And you can simply do that over here in the content box. So I'm just selecting a gray color. And then we'll go to the text settings, and we're using Squada 1 as the font again, and we're enabling uppercase. We'll change the text color. We're using 27 pixels for the text size and a right text orientation. Then we'll go to the spacing settings, and we're going to create some space right above the text module by adding 100 pixels to the top margin. And we'll also add a bottom padding of 20 pixels. And the reason why we're adding this bottom padding is for the bottom border that we'll be adding. So If you want to add a bottom border that has a bit of distance between the text and the border itself, you can do that by using some custom padding, whether you want to add a bottom border or a top border. This will definitely do the job. So then we'll add the border, and it's going to be a bottom border. We're using only one pixel and the following color code. So I'll just change this bottom padding over here for you to notice the difference. So this is 50 pixels. You can play around with these values to create your desired space between the border and the text over here. Okay, so now we have the first module. We can go ahead and clone this module twice because we have three in the first column over here. The only thing we'll need to do is change the spacing of both of these. So we'll just change the top margin into 200 pixels. And I'm just going to copy the spacing styles and add it to the last module over here as well. And then we're going to clone one of these text modules. So I'll just clone the second one, for instance, and place it in the third column. And over here, we'll need to make some changes. So the only thing we'll need to do, I think, is change the text orientation and use left instead of right, which gives us the following result. And we can just clone this text module to have the second one in the third column as well. So here we have the design on desktop. Now we can move on to the last row, and this is one that we'll use to display the goals on smaller screen sizes. So for that, we'll use one column only. And before adding any modules, we're going to open the row settings, go to the background settings, add a white background color. Then we'll go to the sizing settings, enable you use custom gutter width over here and give it a value of 1. And we're going to add some top and bottom padding to this row as well. So we'll use 100 pixels for both the top and the bottom. And we're also going to add that bottom border over here. So we're using 8 pixels. And the following color code. And we're using the same box shadow over here as we've used for the other two rows. So I'll just copy that over here by right-clicking and clicking on copy box shadow styles. And without opening anything, I'm just going to paste the box shadow styles. And then I'll open the row settings again and go to the Advanced tab, open the visibility settings, and I'm going to hide it on desktop. So I've hidden the previous row on phone and tablet, and now I'm doing the same thing, but for desktop. All right, so now I can add my modules over here. I could use the modules that I've created in the previous row, but we have to make quite some changes, so I didn't think it was a bad idea to start from scratch. Again, we're changing the color of these characters over here into a gray color. And then we'll change the text settings. We're using Squad A1 again, and we're enabling uppercase. We're giving it 27 pixels. And we're enabling right text orientation, and then we'll go to the spacing settings, and over here we're going to create some space at the right for this module by adding 150 pixels to the right margin, and we'll also add a bottom padding of 20 pixels again for the bottom border. Then we'll go to the border settings and add one pixel over here. Make sure that we're using the following color code for the border color. All right, so we have the first one over here. So now we can clone this and make some changes to it. So the first thing we'll do is change the text orientation by going to the text settings and changing it to left text orientation. And then we'll also change the spacing values. So instead of having a right margin, we're going to add a left margin instead. And we'll also add 200 pixels to the top margin to create some space between this module and the previous one. And now you can go ahead and clone each one of these modules as many times as you need. So over here, I'm just going to add some top margin again, 200 pixels to create the same kind of space between each one of the modules. And then you can go ahead and clone the modules as many times as you want. And just place them wherever you want to in the row. And this gives the following results on tablet and phone. And this end result. All right, so that was it for this tutorial slash live stream. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. And we hope that you're enjoying this ongoing Divi Design initiative where we try to put something extra into your design toolbox each and every week. If you like all of the content that we're bringing and you would like to share your experience and skills with Divi, make sure that you check out one of the links in the description below and find out how you can contribute to the Elegant Themes blocks. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video.